third-year PhD student at Loughborough University. Today I'm going to talk about my PhD project, but mainly focusing on the methodology and the challenges that I faced during the modeling work and how I solved or couldn't solve them. So the aim of the project is the evaluation of the retrofit decision making process of post-war office buildings by applying dynamic energy simulations to representative building models in order to create a guidance optimizing energy reduction, thermal comfort and costs. To begin with, I'd like to give a few information about the background. As we all know, the energy use in buildings in the UK is 47%, and 17% of these buildings are office buildings, and a quarter of this is post-war office buildings. The replacement rate of new build is only 2%, and post-war office buildings themselves have very unique problems. The diversity in built form of non-domestic buildings and the activity is very high. However, the post-war office buildings themselves has some typical characteristics and architectural properties that is the methodology I applied. These buildings are everywhere in many different functions. They are basically the concrete framed, skeleton frame buildings with lightweight or heavyweight walling. We can see office buildings, university buildings, libraries, with this type of buildings all around. So the idea in this project was, instead of taking a couple of sample buildings, forming an exemplar that represents the building stock so that we can have higher rate of representation within the block, within the stock. To do that, first of all, a model form that is capturing at a high level the stock properties. As I said, there are some typical architectural properties that could be observed in this type of buildings, which is having a corridor type plan, shallow room depth, and natural ventilation and daylighting. They have very, again, typical and obvious problems, having high energy consumption. Also, the era right after the war, the development of construction was so high that the fabric was too poor due to materials and lack of regulations. Therefore, there were toxic materials used. There's a high level of thermal discomfort because of the poor envelope, and also there are aesthetical problems. To be able to form the model, design builder is used. Energy Plus is used for further simulations, and JE Plus is used for parameter study. So first of all, the parameters to be used in models are determined. For that, there are two main parameter groups are formed. One is physical conditions, the other is retrofit packages. Physical conditions are chosen to increase the representation. Here, Islington and Heathrow. Islington represents the inner city that we have. Heath Islands, Heathrow represents the outer city that we have exposed to the surrounding. Weather data is current and future weather data to look at the potential overheating risks. The orientation is around 90 degrees. While heating energy reduction, the first retrofit package is focusing on parterre and Enerfit standards, which captures the envelope improvement, infiltration and heat bridge reductions. Passive cooling energy packages are capturing blinds, overhangs and night ventilations, and the active ones are mixed mode ventilation with heat recovery. Like any other parameter study like this, when we throw all the possible inputs, we are facing with selection clusters. As I said, for example, I applied a blind as a passive cooling energy, but blind is not a one type of thing. It has sub properties that should be evaluated. So bearing all those in mind, we are coming up with hundreds of thousands of possible combination. So to be able to manage this, we applied a staged evaluation method, which first of all, the uncertainty and sensitivity analysis has been run on base case and on the retrofitted base cases to understand which inputs are more sensitive to than the others, and also uncertainty analysis helped us to validate the base case, looking at where are we in terms of energy consumption in comparison with the benchmarks. The further stage was parametric study to be able to optimize individual parameters. As I said, there is blind, but blind has so many other sub-inputs. Like, it could be angle, material, the schedule itself. So to be able to optimize those, a parametric study has run for each group of parameters. And then a detailed analysis has been made on comfort, costs, and energy in zonal level and building level for each physical condition combination. So I have 16 of these tables and a triple in a triple length. The final stage is going to be the creating Pareto forms out of these detailed analyzed combinations, which I can't show yet because I'm at the I'm trying to finalize the third stage. So I'd like to talk about the challenges. Very first one was, of course, dealing with the uncertainties, like all modeling jobs works. Here it is even more important because it is an exemplar. Any number I have as an input has its uncertainty. Therefore, a very very good literature review is needed. I also wanted it to be a guidance as a result product, so that it needs to be realistic. For this, I had some interviews with the industry to understand what are the real life problems and how they are solving them. This had some inputs as well to the project. The third goal was making the correct assumption, which has to be a validated. For that, I used benchmarks, existing measurements, and other studies to compare with my exemplar. And also, the uncertainty analysis work in this bit of work, looking at uncertainty ranges, I could compare with the other works and see where the model and the simulations are. Justification to be able to justify every other input that I had in the simulations, I had to write them down because through the way whenever I write the bit I write, I recognize that there are some missing points. The fifth challenge that I faced and find it very important is that using the program, as it is a totally virtual and program-based project, actually program is your tool, and if you really, really go deep in, it can mislead you. Especially the design builder has some assumptions, the default assumptions, so which one should be very aware of it. The outcomes that as a solution to these sort of challenges, for example, to capture the realistic model due to the interviews I made, that there is one important thing, which is opening characteristics, window opening characteristics on users. This had to be applied in the model, but if you are familiar with the energy plus in general, there are two different levels to look at ventilation in a building. One is airflow network, the other is scheduled ventilation. And I couldn't use airflow network due to lack of some information, but having to be able to apply this phenomenon in scheduled ventilation was a massive discussion to converting airflow network to scheduled ventilation has been an issue that we tried to solve to come up with some averaged air change rates based on airflow network and applied in scheduled ventilation. The other one was building level comfort value. There are different methods to apply, but none of them are dealing with the occupant rate, so that we have to come up with a new idea. Also found some alternatives in literature and applied this to find a new building level of comfort value. And the third one was enriched cost evaluation. The existing projects are mainly looking at investment costs and payback periods. But again, due to interviews with industry, the effect of productivity and the increase in the rents are also have implication on the costs and the decision making due to costs. Finding out all of these and to be able to apply this rather sophisticated understandings to the exemplar model was the challenge of this project. I hope it's been solved. Thank you.